Buenas noches, amigos. ¿Cómo están ustedes? José Cáceres aquí en De Todo Un Poco. Nuestra compañera Milagros García tiene compromisos personales, por eso no estará con nosotros en el día de hoy. Ya estará con nosotros en próximas entregas. Señores, la República Dominicana de Júbilo. En el día de hoy, Adrián Beltré fue inducido al Salón de la Fama de Cooperstown. Y la verdad es que este hombre, que lo dio todo durante más de 14, 15 temporadas, pues ha colocado la bandera de República Dominicana muy en alto. Adrián Beltré se convierte en el quinto dominicano que llega al Salón de Cooperstown del béisbol de Grandes Ligas. Vamos a recordar, el primero fue Juan Marichal, nuestro ícono, lanzador. Luego vino, años después, Pedro Martínez, el astro de los Medias Rojas de Boston. Luego continuó entonces el recio bateador Vladimir Guerrero, el jonronero dominicano David Ortiz, que también lo hizo por el conjunto de Boston, y ahora el quinto lo es este joven jugador que estuvo muchos años con el equipo de Texas, Adrián Beltré. Vamos a recordar primeramente cuando recibió la llamada en enero pasado, donde se le comunicó de manera oficial que con un 95% Adrián Beltré estaba siendo electo para el pabellón de la fama.
Cooperstown, New York.
You ready?
Yeah.
Answer.
John, I'm gonna leave. Go to the
answer.
Hello.
Hello, may I speak with Adrian Beltré, please?
Yes, sir. This is him.
Adrian, this is Jack O'Connell, the baseball, calling you from the Baseball Hall of Fame in Cooperstown, New York. Your new second home, the baseball writers have elected you to the Hall of Fame.
Thank you so much. Well, it's official.
You know, we in bumped with the moment that you got the call. We got to watch it, but what was going through your mind and heart internally when you got the call that you're now a Hall of Famer?
I was glad that it was over. Obviously, I'm honored. It's something that is amazing to be even just on the ballot. And to be able to now call myself a Hall of Fame is something that I even dream of. You know, I always wanted to be a decent baseball player, good baseball player, but I never thought about being a Hall of Fame. Now that I'm in, it's really an honor. I'm humbled to be called that. And, you know, it was kind of super sweet and nice the way you got that call, and you when you see Cooperstown and the phone call, and yeah, kind of settled in. Okay, man, I think you are gonna make the Hall of Fame, so it's really nice.
Bien, ahora Freddy, vamos a ver los mejores momentos cuando Adrián Beltré conectó su hit número 3000 en las Grandes Ligas, uniéndose a un selecto grupo no solamente de dominicanos sino de jugadores que han pasado por Grandes Ligas, que han conectado 3,000 o más imparables en su carrera. Vamos a ver ahí cuando Adrián compartió con su familia, sus hijos, su esposa, cuando ese momento memorable conectó su hit número 3,000. Vamos a verlo y nos vamos por ahí mismo a la pausa y regresamos en breve.
Everybody on their feet at Globe Life Park. The 3-0. Bouncer. Around second, heading to third, Mazzara. Beltré goes for two, and it's a stand-up double. And there it is, number 3,000 for Adrian Beltré.
Yeah.
his family, and his fans.
Continuando con el espacio de Todo un Poco en este programa especial de deportes, tal y como ocurrió la semana pasada, vamos a dar filete para todos nuestros amigos televidentes. Miren, el equipo de Boston Celtics en la NBA logró su corona número 18. Y la verdad es que esta franquicia, pues que donde han pasado grandes baloncestistas que ya están en el Salón de la Fama, pues logró vencer a Dallas Mavericks en la serie final, donde Jaylen Brown, Jason Tatum, también el dominicano Al Horford, brillaron a también Derek White, un hombre importante en la posición de armador. No hay duda de que llevaron a Boston, y eso fue una locura, cuando el conjunto de los Celtics se llevó la corona. Días después entonces vino lo que fue el desfile, donde la ciudad de Boston prácticamente completo se tiró a la calle a disfrutar la corona número 18. Vamos a disfrutar de esos grandes momentos de la corona número 18 del equipo de Boston Celtics en la NBA 2024.
Y después de las frustraciones, ¿no?, de hace par de temporadas atrás, tú dijiste, esto no nos dividió, esto nos hizo más fuertes.
Celtics, come on up here, you guys. You guys have stood on team all season long, unbreakable bond. So I'm just going to throw out questions. Come on up, get up here close to me. I'm just going to throw out questions. Whoever wants to answer, answer. Except the first question has to be to
las tropas. La primera pregunta va para Al Horford. Campeonatos consecutivos para los Florida Gators y hoy campeón de la NBA.
What has the weight been like?
El peso que se va a quitar de encima. Dice, ha sido mucho tiempo, mucho trabajo. Estoy muy orgulloso de ser parte de este equipo. Y gloria a Dios también de parte de Horford.
And now you finally are a champion. Can you describe to me what's going through your head right now?
Descríbeme ahora lo que significa ser un campeón. Dice, no, no lo puedo creer, lo hicimos. Estamos aquí. Pero así me lo imaginé, juntos en el Garden, con los fanáticos, con quienes nos siguen en el Garden.
Bien, y como el dominicano Al Horford fue un hombre clave a pesar de sus 38 años, vamos a ver ahora un highlight, vamos a ver los mejores momentos de Al Horford en gran parte de la temporada. Y el criollo, aunque no lo ha dicho, pero tiene una opción de contrato de 9.5 millones de dólares para el año que viene. Y de acuerdo a declaraciones de algunos dirigentes y jugadores, parece que el criollo se va a quedar en el conjunto para agotar esa cláusula de ese contrato. Y quién quita de que también pudiera renegociarlo por 1 o 2 años más. Disfruten Al Horford, sus mejores momentos en la NBA 2024. Nos vamos a la pausa por ahí mismo.
His team needed it, but they wanted to keep seeing. Now Trae Young is coming into the game. Let's give this unit 4 or 5 more plays and see if they can build off of that.
What a rejection from Horford.
Position to put a stranglehold on this if they can get stops. Philadelphia, you can't get shy and get the ball to your star.
Here he is with it. Right at the elbow against Horford, rips through, got to the rim, got it blocked. Horford hijacked it, and the Celtics with a chance to take the lead. Here's White, got a screen from Horford, trying to fake out Bogdanovich, roll to the rim, Horford looks to give it up. Williams puts it down, and a foul. It wasn't a classic Time Lord dunk, but it counts all the same.
The rotation, but it's the dribble penetration. Horford receives the ball automatically, once he gets it in the middle, he knows that Robert Williams is cutting on the baseline, and it's only so much Okongwu could do. He helped, but then he had to try to get back to Williams, and that time couldn't get it done. And
Tucker on Tatum. Smart fakes the handoff out to Grant Williams. Maxey lost it to Brogdon. Horford pulls the three. Got it! Al Horford with another one of those timely Horford buckets.
Horford can't hit the three. Here's Murray soaring in, and Horford there. You're getting an incredible display of Boston's transition defense over these last few possessions.
16 for Brown. Celtics by a dozen. Embiid blocked by Horford. His third block of the game. And it's Celtic ball. This place erupting right now.
He is flat out getting it done against the MVP of the league.
Damn. Whoa. That was a rope from 2 o'clock ago.
Look at that. Jason Tatum showing you. I got the vision. Jason Tatum. You get to see this.
Look at that. Mike, you were right. That was a line drive. That was on a rope.
Jason Tatum, watch what he does.
I give you the goggles because I can see everything. That's right. Everything. And the bench says, yes, you can. You can see everything.
That's five offensive rebounds. Boston's not missing much. And when they do, they get it back. And now their defense again takes over.
Smart had the steal. Horford will finish it off. Robinson
a consecutive elimination game for these Celtics, much like last year. Nice feed inside. Horford to Robert Williams.
Once the shot went up, he had the advantage in time.
Atlanta trying to get their offense recalibrated here. Hunter turned back. Al Horford was right there. Smart three on one point. Beautiful fake and lays it in. He has been
perfect. Gets to a spot inside to Smart. One more to Horford. One more to Brogdon. He misfires. Tatum with the offensive board. And another opportunity for the Celtics. Just a step faster. Horford with the punch. Oh, he sent it with his chest, and they take the lead.
His chest and his hips had a little sauce at the end of that. First lead since 1917.
Game 7 of the series back in Boston, if needed, on Saturday night. Tatum, lead bounce, Smart kicks. Horford from deep, get it! Boston retakes the lead.
And Smart move by Marcus Smart. Knowing that they were going to help middle on Jason Tatum, he cut back door, forced the defense to have to help, kicked it over to a wide open Al Horford.
And beat at the free throw line. They load up boxes and elbows. Horford blocked it again. That's two times he's packed and beat shot. Brown in transition. Smart. Three. Butter.
Robinson sets up for a two-point shot.
I mean, what a beautiful rejection here by Horford.
El torpedero Elis de la Cruz de la República Dominicana del conjunto de los Rojos del Cincinnati sigue encendido en candela. El muchacho ha venido este año con más poder, ya lleva 16 cuadrangulares, sobre las 40 y tanto empujadas, y no hay duda de que está enloqueciendo al béisbol de Grandes Ligas con su velocidad y un brazo mortífero que tiene este joven jugador de Sabana Grande de Boyat. Vamos a disfrutar también de unos highlights de Elis de la Cruz, el joven jugador torpedero de los Tigres del Licey, que está teniendo una gran temporada, está buscando su consolidación en el béisbol de las Grandes Ligas, un muchacho bastante joven, que apenas firmó por $60,000 para que ustedes vean que el bono no indica la calidad del jugador en muchas ocasiones. Elis de la Cruz sigue jugando buena pelota, el hombre tiene buena defensa y un brazo de cañón que tiene a todo el mundo temblando cada vez que están corriendo las bases. Además de que su velocidad también ya lleva sobre las 30 y tanto de bases robadas, lo que indica que es un hombre que tiene poder y velocidad al mismo tiempo. Veamos a Eli de la Cruz y sus acciones en este 2024.
And now a second plate appearance for De La Cruz. Smash to right center. First big league hit. And here he goes. Lightning speed. De La Cruz up to second. A stand-up double. That was 112 off the bat.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show.
But in his later plate appearances, it would go from loud chants of Ellie to tennis match golf tournament silence.
Anticipation to see what...
Oh, goodness! That ball had a family! In game two, his first home run, a two-run bomb!
John, that wasn't just a home run. That ball almost exited the ballpark.
Ellie De La Cruz, a devastating homer his first time.
De La Cruz bashes to right center. Is he for real? He's gonna go three. Easily has a triple.
Folks, you better come down to the ballpark. You better come down here at Cincinnati and watch this young man play.
He goes, pitch up, throw down. First steal, Ellie De La Cruz.
Just freeing him up and just do what he does. And good read right there. You saw him look like he went first move. Not even close. I think it's the stride length and the frequency, obviously, that allows him to run so fast, but it's so fun just to watch him play.
He goes, good jump, pitch up, throw down from Perez. Lost off the glove, helmet pops free, De La Cruz bursts for third. His speed impacts the game. A swipe of second, and then he forces the mistake. He's 90 feet away with nobody out. Chop left side, in between, backhand, longer throw. Up the line, Steer tag, got him. Nice job by both De La Cruz and Steer as they conspire to cut down the catcher.
The Reds certainly have that in bunches, like Ellie De La Cruz.
De La Cruz, opposite way, Profar back. Ellie De La Cruz, opposite way for home run number two. It's a 4-1 game.
Well, this is a nice adjustment right here by Ellie De La Cruz. A lot of pitches out away from him, and he's going to have to commit to hitting that ball out over the plate.
Faces Reds phenom Ellie De La Cruz.
That is blitzed to right center field. Off the top of the wall. De La Cruz storms up to second base. He nearly had a home run by inches. That was 117 off the bat.
Ellie De La Cruz was drinking three bags right here. Once he turns it on, man, that kid is some kind of fun to watch. De La Cruz changes everything.
First pitch in the air to right. Acuna back at the wall. Gone! De La Cruz does it again. Home run number three on the year. His second of the homestand. And his two-run shot has the Reds back within one. This man is electric.
Ellie De La Cruz, the first man of the World Series era, goes back to 1903, 20 hits, 5 steals, 3 bombs in his first 15 games.
Broke his bat. That's in the center. Base hit. Windmill on McClain. Harrison center lob to second. McClain slides home safely. De La Cruz. He is a triple shy. 3 for 3. And the Reds within one.
3 for 3. Triple shy of the cycle. 3 ribbies. He is hitting 356.
De La Cruz, right center. Down base hit. Could he go 3? India around third. India scores. It's a cycle. This rookie in 2 weeks of the big leagues posts the first cycle for a Red since 1989. Ellie Mania.
Jonathan India, the free runner. Ellie De La Cruz leads it off.
That is driven hard to right center. Awkward read by India. Furious windmill on. De La Cruz shoots up to second. Throw to second. Head first punch. India scores, tied. Ribbing double.
People are going to stop pitching to this young man right here. This is a changeup out over the plate.
He's a base-stealing threat. He goes. First pitch misses up. Throw down late. That's another steal for the lightning quick. Ellie De La Cruz, the fastest man in the world. This is only his 25th game in the big leagues, and he's got double-digit steals.
You say that the Reds have now, what, 93
home runs on the year. The average major league team has 100.
De La Cruz trying to add to it. He crushes. Upper deck right center.
Take that 94.
A De La Cruz missile. He sizzled it into the second deck. A 5-1 Reds lead.
Vargas off. Sharp ground ball, De La Cruz. Backhand, outfield grass throw. Got it.
Oh, my.
He is just different. With De La Cruz batting left-handed, Anderson so deep and off the line, Friedel can take a giant lead.
Line beyond the Adames base hit. Friedel scores the Reds' first lead on the bat of Elly De La Cruz. It is 6-5 Cincinnati.
Now let's see if the Reds can tack on. De La Cruz goes. Pitch called a strike, throw down on a skip late. Another steal for Elly De La Cruz. That's his 14th swipe, caught just twice in the show. He takes off again. Pitch down and in, fame throw. There's no chance. Well, two steals.
De La Cruz had already looked a couple of times at Brian Anderson, knowing that if he got a jump.
He's going home. The throw. He stole home. The most thrilling man in baseball.
Como ya hemos hablado en otras ocasiones, la República Dominicana estará en los Juegos Olímpicos a partir del próximo 26 de este mes. Marilady Paulino es una de las medallas prácticamente segura, Dios mediante, hay que ponerlo primero a él por delante porque la muchacha tiene todas las condiciones, está entrenando muy bien, tiene ya varias semanas en París, adaptándose al tiempo, al clima, a la comida. Y eso es muy importante porque acaba de ganar su última pata de lo que es la Liga Diamante con 49-20. Y Marilady, quien ya ganó plata en los Juegos Olímpicos de Tokio 2021 en los 400 metros, ahora es la gran favorita para llevarse la medalla de oro. Pero Cristian Pinales es un boxeador con unas grandes condiciones, un muchacho bastante fornido, sabe boxear, tiene pegada. Ya ganó medalla de oro en los pasados Juegos Centroamericanos y del Caribe y también en los Juegos Panamericanos y también logró su clasificación a París. Vamos a disfrutar, deleítense mirando este combate del dominicano Cristian Pinales, quien estará en los Juegos Olímpicos de París y ojalá llegue bastante lejos porque tiene todas las condiciones y no nos vamos a sorprender si el criollo se mete en una de las medallas para la República Dominicana en las Olimpiadas. Veamos a Cristian Pinales con los puños de la República Dominicana.
Categoría de los 80 kilogramos. Esquina azul, Jorge Caicedo de Colombia. Esquina roja, Cristian Pinales de República Dominicana.
Thank you.
como dice nuestra compañera Milagros García y Freddy Scott, nuestro camarógrafo, lo mejor se deja para lo último. Y así es. Como ustedes saben que Adrian Beltré, ya un señor salón de la fama de Cooperstown, tuvo muchas anécdotas en su carrera. Y una de ellas es que no le gustaba que le topasen por la cabeza cuando llegaba al dugout. Y Elvis Andrews, el venezolano, su enllave, pues le jugaba muchas bromas, tanto en el terreno de juego como en el dugout. Vamos a disfrutar, vamos a ver, a deleitarnos con este pequeño resumen que hemos preparado del dominicano, el ya inmortal de Cooperstown, Adrian Beltré, con sus mejores jugadas en el béisbol de las Grandes Ligas. Estaremos con ustedes en una próxima ocasión aquí por el Canal 19 con otro espacio de todo un poco. Feliz resto de la noche y nos vemos.
No, Cole to work here in the eighth inning. The first pitch to him. Pitching is Powell, popped up. Beltré. We haven't seen them have a chance to play that game lately. It's nice to see him back in good season form with Poppy. Matt Adams is going to pitch in against the Marquis Bunch. We were just talking about him for 3 innings. The damage he's done is a pinch hitter.
The 2-2. Popped him up. Beltré and Andrews. Adrian, the elder statesman over there, taking charge. Knocking Elvis back. Dyson ready. And the right-hander deals. Shallow left field. Beltré and Andrews angling out. Elvis Andrews making the call and the catch for out number two. Whether it's April or September, these guys probably go at it if they find each other on Christmas Day. Doesn't matter. Venable's looking at both of them like, what are you guys doing?
Well, that's the kind of play that Elvis is a shortstop. He yelled for it. Adrian went through the motions just to make sure if it came to him next time he'll know how to do it, but he let Elvis catch that one.
He was number two in Major League Baseball with his average, number one in the National League, and he's 0-for-4. Left side, it is Andrews with Beltré playing around.
He went for the deke. I did.
He decoyed. So did the guy calling it.
He decoyed both of us. Look at this. Oh, that's great. I'll tell you, you talk about a guy who loves to play.
And Marwin Gonzalez, switch hitter, pops this one up. Beltré, yeah, and then he wanted it. And I think he hit Elvis to get him away from it. It's all fun and games until you get slapped by Adrian's glove.
Elvis said, I know better than that. I know. You don't have to say anything. I know. Shortstop's supposed to take charge, but I know.
That didn't go the way he wanted it, so he turned to pitching, and it's worked out pretty well. This one popped up on the infield, left side. Beltré and Andrews right behind Adrian Beltré is Elvis Andrews to make the catch. One gone. Elvis saying, okay, this is my area here, and that over there is your area. Stay out of my area. And the only time the Mariners got their leadoff man aboard in an inning. And Morales grounded into a 4-6-3 double play that took care of it. Here he's going to pop out for the second out of inning number 7. Elvis is there right behind Adrian Beltré, who's explaining to him where his line is, and Elvis can't go there. Elvis is not. I'm back on the grass.
Elvis is saying, I don't mind you doing that, but just don't come too close. Look, there's the line
there's
right
the line.
There. Don't
That's
go
right.
past the line, dude. No smiles in that little.
No, that was semi-serious.
And you know, really, Adrian's a little too close to him right there.
And he popped him up. Infield fly rule will be in effect. Beltré and Andrews coming down. It's Adrian Beltré. Elvis right next to him, and Adrian's looking like, What is he doing?
Elvis did that on purpose. Yeah, in that particular case, there's not much at risk. Because right. If you miss it, the batter's out anyway. But that was just the case. Elvis is just sticking his nose where it doesn't belong right there.
Well, I'm sure you Ranger fans have seen this. Maybe not that exact one, but it's always something new with these guys. Seeing Adrian smack Elvis on the head when he's gotten too close.
Elvis was laughing before he even got there.
The time off will change his fortunes. Off of Beltre, over to Elvis, the hard throw, and they got him.
Nice play.
Good reaction by Elvis on the carom off of Adrian Beltre's glove. That'll go down as a 5-6-3 putout.
As Ellis Wheeler hits this ball pretty good, and Beltre gets caught in between. It's a tough hop to take. It goes off the side of his glove, and Elvis is right there to pick it up, and he uses that cannon that he's got. You see this, that's a tough play to make for Beltre. And Elvis in great position. Gets the ricochet and fires over to first base for the out.
Now the 1-1. Line over the glove of Elvis out in the left center field. Lowry, a big turn at first, and he will hang on as Leonis Martin got over to cut it off. Well, a leadoff single for the A's here in the second. That'll bring up Josh Reddick.
Curveball to Lowry and lines it over Elvis's head. Adrian's jumping up in the air with him, see if he can't get him a little higher, but that was even too hard for both of them jumping at the same time.
Was Andrews, I think, doing
some midge out of his
eyes. Midge prepare for Adrian Beltre. They don't bite, but that doesn't mean that they're not huge pests.
They didn't want to stick his fingers in his eyes. He was trying to blow it out of his eye.
All the way around. In the air, well hit left center field. Way back up the alley, Cooper.
That's unbelievable. That's just like Joey Votto, what he did to Yu Darvish in spring training. Threw him two slow curveballs in a row. He threw Beltre two slow curveballs, spun him all the way around on one. He took the next one deep down on one knee. That's priceless right there.
The lead home run number 396 for Adrian Beltre. And Rugnet Odor almost got clocked on that. Now the on-deck serve will be the DH. Beltre a drive, high and deep to left field. Way back, goodbye.
And that... He's got a Beltre's hat on?
Yeah.
Oh, man, that's funny. He got a fastball. He got a pitch that time. Take that, Elvis.
Offseason before last. Beltre rifles one to center. Going back, Gomez. He can't get there. That ball is gone. Adrian Beltre, a line drive home run. It is 7-2 Rangers.
All you could say through the first 2.5, 3 weeks of the season is Beltre looks exactly like he did the last couple of months when he knocked in about a run per game, one of the guys carrying the offense. And he might be playing even better defensively right now than he was last year. So that's great to see him this healthy in April.
I was just trying to get a good pitch to swing. Obviously, he threw a slider, he hung it. I was able to put a good spin on it.
They missed him. The veteran, you can't get him.
That's right.
That's funny.
Are we done? Oh, no, we're not done. Okay, well, they didn't manage to get your jersey off, and they couldn't get you with the Gatorade.
I'm too quick for them.
Yeah, I guess so.
Rangers maintaining their 5-3 lead. Adrian Beltre, after chasing away Elvis Andrus on that pop-up.
They pretty much have a running dialogue the whole game.
Yeah.
And between innings, I don't know what Elvis said to him, but he said something then ran away. Adrian threw his glove at him between innings. Watch, here comes.
Elvis a drive deep to left field into the corner.
If it's fair, it is off the top of the wall. Odor being waved around third. And Correa can't handle the relay throw. Odor scores. Elvis Andrus, an RBI double. It is 5-2 Texas.
Well, Elvis, you talked about turning on an inside pitch.
Elvis.
Yeah, he was pretty sure it was out. Uh-oh.
Elvis might take some heat for that. Nah, you know what? Double in an RBI, you can't take any heat for that. He's going to get a double anyway. Fields got that one inside, and Brett just lifted it right over the first baseman's head. Softly for an RBI double. All it takes. Brett had a walk, and now he's got a double and an RBI to go along with it. Elvis is talking. Elvis is talking about his home run trot.
Yeah.
He wouldn't even shake his hand.
You read Adrian, he said, not even close. Talking about that. It was 6 inches from the top of the wall, but that's not even close.
When you're hitting 30 home runs, you can go into your try.
That's right.
But get double digits first. Now they're smiling. Good. I was getting worried there for a second.
De todo un poco.